हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर पीसी कंबोडिया, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, बीएसआर गवर्नमेंट आर्ट्स कॉलेज, अलवर, राजस्थान। दिस वीडियो क्लास इज़ फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ एमए फाइनल इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर फर्स्ट। नॉमनक्लेचर्ड एज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म इन सम ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटीज। This paper is also called as Literary Theories, since it contains the ancient and modern literary theories. The first critic that we come across in this paper is the great teacher Aristotle and his Poetics. Aristotle was a Greek, and the language which he deals with is also Greek. So his criticism is in Greek language. When we read Aristotle, then originally, if we do not know the Greek language, then we are reading the translations. Humphrey House translates. Bywater's translation is there. Then there are other several books on poetics. Malcolm Heath is yet another translator. All these translators are translating the original script. Sometimes they translate in detail, but sometimes their translations are economic. What we see is that there is a bulk of difference, because the original script as written by Aristotle is at some places mutilated, or words are not available, or if at all he describes some of the concepts, then they are interpreted differently. So we shall be seeing to it that there is no difficulty in understanding Aristotle, and if we face any difficulty, then we should switch over to the another translator, that what could be the exact meaning of the terms used by the great teacher Aristotle. When Aristotle was around 20 years of age, he joined an academy which was established by Plato. There he used to listen his eloquences. Eloquences could be called as oral lectures because of the oral lectures delivered by his teacher Plato. His interest arose in poetry and fine arts, and he also started writing eloquences and delivering them. Poetics is such a collection of his opinion as a critic. The first concept that he deals with is mimics. We know mimicry, monoacting, comes from mimics. Yet another word is imitation. Imitation means we are copying. Sometimes we have a model in our mind. Either we have seen it at a place, and if we want another copy of that model, we take the artist, maybe in form of a carpenter or a sculpturist or a designer or a painter, and produce the model before him, or we describe it through our imagination if that model is not available easily. And Aristotle also refers to that model. His model is not concrete that can be seen or touched. He talks about such models in the theory of mimics or imitation, where the essence is involved in copying. Say, for example, if an object is perfect to be seen and visualized according its size, color, then it is so easy to copy for the artist. But if the model is concrete and it needs to be copied in such form where intelligence is to be copied or rhyme, rhythm, tone, intonation is to be copied, then it becomes really challenging. Aristotle talks about such copying or the mimicry involved in the copying of certain models. According to Plato, the theory of imitation or mimics takes an artist away from reality. But Aristotle refutes his teacher, Plato. He says, no, the theory of imitation or mimics brings an artist closer to reality. Now we will have to understand what these two great critics mean when one of them, Plato, says it takes away from reality, and Aristotle says that it takes us closer to reality. Then it is the skill involved in the process of copying. We have a model that is called as the original. Then the artist comes in front of the real model and tries to copy. If the artist creates a lot of difference where we are reminded of the original and at that of the copied model, then we are being moved away from the original. In that case, the mimics or the craft of copying will take us away from reality, because we are reminded of the difference between the original and the copied model. Suppose the artist or the craftsman is so excellent in his art that he copies and he does not leave any difference in between the copied model and the original model, and we are confused to decide which is original and which is the copied form. In that case, we are taken closest to the original or closest to the reality. In that case, the art or the craft involved in copying is excellent, and the theory of mimics brings us closer to reality, and it is the meaning of the great teacher Aristotle. Aristotle says that while we are copying, we are reminded of three factors: manner of imitation, mode of imitation, object of imitation. Manner is the way how we copy. Say, for example, Aristotle says that the artist may enter the process of copying the creation, and he may not get involved. He may remain outside. and he goes on writing. As it happens in the case of storytelling or poetry, the entire draft is there in front of us. Of course, it has been created by the artist or the writer, but the writer is not there and his presence is realized only, and his presence is almost the same from beginning to the end. But there is yet one more process. He may enter the process of writing through some character, and he goes on writing and writing through that character. Then there is one more way of imitation, that is the manner or the mode, that is through different characterization one after the other, that is in form of dramatic creation. The artist takes in the role of certain characters. Sometimes he becomes this character and writes a dialogue for the same character. Again he resumes the position of some another character, and thereafter some another character. Then we have dramatic poetry. Then we need the medium. For an artist who is a painter, the colors are the medium. He makes use of dark color, bright color, and brush. He also takes help of canvas or the paper. Oil paints are there. It all becomes a process which refers to the second point, that is medium. Then there is object of imitation. Here Aristotle says that Polygnotus paints human nature better than average. Poisson paints them as worse than average. And Aristotle also talks about man in average nature. He says that when man's nature better than average is being copied and he meets his ill fate, it gives the chance to tragedy. When man's nature worse than average is being copied, it comes to comedy. Aristotle does not take much interest in man's average as it is. This way his theory of imitation proceeds. We shall be taking some another point from Aristotle's Poetics in our next video class. Thank you so much.